So we are doing Laplace transforms, and in the previous lecture we did number of formulas. Let's recall them before doing problems. So what is Laplace transform of a function? I list all the formulas here one by one, and then we will use those in the problems. What is Laplace transform of a function? Recall it. It is integral 0 to infinity e power minus px fx dx. What is inverse Laplace of fp? Because this is finally a function of p. So what is inverse Laplace of fp? It is fx. Then Laplace transforms of standard functions, exponential function Laplace is 1 over p minus a, provided p greater than a. Laplace transform of x power n is gamma n plus 1 over n over p power n plus 1. Laplace transform of sine function, sine ax, a is a constant, a over p square plus a square, cos ax, Laplace transform is p over p square plus a square. If it is hyperbolic, what is the difference here?
P square minus a square.
Minus a square, in case it is hyperbolic. Likewise, if it is cos hyperbolic ax, then it is p over p square minus a square. So I'm not writing those. Now, what is Laplace of e power ax fx? The shifting rule. Capital F p minus a. Means in the Laplace transform of fx, that is fp, replace p by p minus a. Laplace transform of f prime x, first derivative of x, is p f p minus f 0. Laplace transform of the integral 0 to x f t dt, it is fp over p. Laplace transform of x times fx, it is minus 1 times df over dp, or you can say f prime p. One more. Laplace transform of fx over x, it is integral p to infinity fp dp or ft dt, whatever variable you choose. Limits are from p to infinity. So these are the formulas that we did in the previous lecture. Okay, now we will do mixed problems on Laplace transform as well as inverse Laplace transform. See the first one. In all these problems, one of these or more than one of these would be used. So what is inverse Laplace of 1 over p into p square plus 1? That you have to do.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, we'll divide it into three partial fractions.
No,
p plus iota, p minus iota.
No, don't go to iota. You can do in a simple way. Of course, you can use that. What do you think, which formula can help us among these 11?
So we can multiply, divide by p. Then in denominator, it would be p square and p square plus 1.
Okay. Can you use formula number 9 to solve
yes,
this problem?
Sir. Yes, sir.
because it is FP over P. What is FP here?
Sine. 1 upon P square plus 1.
1 over P square plus 1. So what is inverse Laplace of FP? You know this directly. 1 over P square plus 1. So formula number 5 you can apply. It is Laplace transform of
sine x.
Now next step, you want to divide it by P. So if you divide by P, you see you can take this L that side. And L, Laplace inverse of FP over P is what? 0 to x FT dt. What is FT? This is FX, right? So what is FT? Sine t. You can solve this integral easily. It is minus cos t 0 to x. So upper limit minus lower limit cos x plus 1. So finally its inverse Laplace is 1 minus cos x. Okay. So you need to keep these formulas in your mind, and one of the formula you can apply, one or more than one, depending on the problem. Because here FP is 1 over P square plus 1, so I know its inverse Laplace. Now this FP is divided by P, that's why I'm using it. Okay. Now let's see the next problem. Find Laplace of x sine x. How to do it? Which formula will help you?
In second one.
First you should write Laplace of sine x. That is, can you use the fifth one?
1 over p square plus 1.
Good. Now multiply this by x. If you multiply fx by x, what is the effect? See here, formula number 10. What should you do on the right side? Minus 1 times?
Minus 1 cos x.
No. You need to differentiate it with respect to p. Look at formula number 10. If you know Laplace of fx, then multiplication by x means differentiate Laplace of fx and multiply by minus 1.
Minus 2p upon p square plus 1 raised to the power 2.
Yes. The minus is already there, so you can write 2p over p square plus 1 whole square. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so as I said, depending on the problem, you have to think. And these are not difficult. You need to see different types of problems. See the next one. What if I divide it by x? If I divide it by x, then which formula will help me?
11th one.
First, you should write Laplace of sine x, that is 1 over p square plus 1. Division by x means integral p to infinity, fp dp, or you can write in t, it is up to you. Okay, let me write p square plus 1 dp. So what is the integral? Solve it further. Tan inverse p. Limits p to infinity. Tan inverse infinity, you know, is pi by 2 minus tan in place of pp only. Or you can write it cot inverse p, it's up to you. Okay. Is it fine?
Yes.
Now let me ask you a very interesting question. See whether you are able to answer it or not. You will see the power of Laplace transform in this problem. Suppose you don't know Laplace transform, and I ask you find the value of this integral. What will you do? Can you integrate sin x over x?
It's non-integrable.
Not integrable. And you know its answer is pi by 2. Can we take the help of Laplace transform? You know Laplace of, see how can we use Laplace transform to get this integral? Laplace transform of sin x over x is pi by 2 minus tan inverse p. Just now we have proved it in the previous problem. By definition, what is Laplace transform of sin x over x? 0 to infinity e power minus px sin x over x. You know p is a parameter on both sides. I can choose any value of p. So which value of p can provide me this integral?
0.
0. So put p equal to 0. You see value of this integral is pi by 2. How simple it is using Laplace transform. Okay, so take care of this kind of integrals where exponential is involved or some function where you can find Laplace and use this value parameter to get the integral. Okay. So very difficult looking integrals can be solved using Laplace transform. What is Laplace of cos x over x? Can you do it yourself and tell me your answer?
Sir,
do the same as you did for sin x.
Sir, we'll first use the sixth formula.
Yes, do it.
And then,
I want to listen the final answer, not the procedure. Cos x Laplace transform is p over p square plus 1, and division by x means integration from 0 to p to infinity. Now the task is to integrate this function.
P square plus 1 is equal to p. So 1 by 2 ln p square plus 1.
1 by 2 ln p square plus 1. What is after that? Upper limit minus lower limit. What is upper limit?
Infinity.
Infinity. So finally, what is your conclusion?
Not
yes, Laplace transform of this function does not exist finitely. Okay. So it's not like that whatever function is given to you and you are always in a position to find the Laplace transform. Depends on the function. So we can see further problems on Laplace transform. See this problem of inverse Laplace transform, p plus 7 over p square plus 2p plus 5. How can you manage it? Linear over quadratic. Think over it, then I will tell you. How can we manage its inverse Laplace? We have these formulas, okay? You can use any of those.
Sir, we can make it p plus 1 whole square plus 4.
Yes, make perfect square for the quadratic expression. You can write it p plus 1 whole square plus
4. 4, which is 2 square.
Yes, 2 square. What next?
Sir, two different integral, two partial.
You can write it p plus 1 plus 6. Okay. After that, you can write two different Laplace inverse. It is p plus 1 over p plus 1 whole square plus 4. Then 6 times inverse Laplace 1 over p plus 1 whole square plus 4.
So first term is cos 2x.
Yes. What is inverse Laplace of this function?
It would be term of an exponential multiplied by cos x function. And then exponential would be e power 1 x.
Yes, yes. Now you should see here. You should see here this shifting property. This one. P goes to p minus a if the function is multiplied by p power a x. Here p, everywhere p goes to p plus 1. It means the original function is multiplied by which function?
e power minus x.
After that, what is left? P over p square plus 4. P over p square plus 4, you can think from here. It is cos 2x. You can think like this. First write Laplace of cos 2x. That is p over p square plus 4. After that, you have multiplied this function by p power minus x, so that p has gone to p plus 1. You understand this, right? Likewise, here, p...
6, p power minus x, sine 2x.
So you need to adjust p, a here, right? What is a? 2. So divide and multiply by 2. After that, what is it?
Sine 2x.
It is e power minus x sine 2x. It is sine 2x, but because p is p plus 1, so you have to multiply sine 2x by e power minus x. So notice these steps carefully, what I have done here. And it's very simple. Whatever answer you are writing, do the Laplace back. You should get the previous step. Laplace of cos 2x is p over p square plus 4. Multiplication by e power minus x means p has gone to p plus 1. Okay, so in this type of problems, you need to do the manipulations that I have shown here. So you can always manage linear over quadratic. Even it is 1 over quadratic, you can manage, right? Because it is here you can see it is a case of 1 over quadratic. So you have to make perfect square.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, here we have in sine ax formula a upon p square plus a square.
Yes.
Sir, if we have a function x square plus 4x plus 2. X square plus 4x plus 2.
1 over x square plus
4x plus 2.
4x plus 2, okay. Then
sir, minus ke liye to hamare paas to formula nahi
hai. We have hyperbolic function, you have, isn't it?
Okay, sir.
You have hyperbolic function. Okay, let's do it. It is L inverse 1 over, you can write it x plus 2 whole square minus how much?
Root 2 square.
2 square.
Root 2 square.
Sorry, root 2 square. Now what is needed here, root 2, adjust it. What is it? What is its inverse Laplace? You know, a over x square minus a square cos p square.
Sir, again,
seventh
formula.
Not x, you should write p here. We are using the notation p. To avoid the confusion, use p. Yes.
Sir, again, seventh formula we use.
E power minus 2x because p has gone to p plus 2. And a over p square minus a square means sine hyperbolic
root 2x.
Root 2x, yes. Okay, so can do this kind of problems. Noted?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see this problem. Inverse Laplace of 2p square minus 6p plus 5 divided by p cube minus 6p square plus 11p minus 6.
Sir, for below cubic equation, we have roots 1, 2, and 3.
Sorry?
We have roots 1, 2, and 3 for the cubic equation.
Yes, 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 yes. Think over it. How can we manage?
That does it.
Because for cube, we have no rule, right? So let's make factors in the denominator if possible. I think it is possible.
P minus 1, P minus 2, P minus
3. P minus 1, P minus 2, P minus 3. Now just make partial fractions. A over P minus 1, B over P minus 2, C over P minus 3. Can you tell me these constants directly without doing much calculations? Do you
yes,
know?
Sir, leaving P minus 1, we'll put 1 in the remaining function.
Yes, for example, you need capital A, so put P equal to 1 in this whole expression except this factor, right? Means 2 into 1 square minus 6 into 1 plus 5 divided by 1 minus 2 into 2 minus 3 over P minus 1. Likewise, for getting B, what to do? Put P equal to 2 in this whole expression except this factor, P minus 2. Okay, so this is shortcut when the factors are different. You can write ABC easily. So once you have obtained ABC, what is inverse Laplace A you will calculate, okay? What is inverse Laplace of 1 over P minus 1?
E power X.
It is very simple. 1 over P minus A means here 1 over P minus 1, so A into E power X. Likewise, B times E power 2X, C times E power 3. Clear? So sometimes you may use partial fractions, those may help you. So as I said earlier, it depends on the problem. There is no general rule for every problem. Depending on the given function, you need to do the manipulations. And manipulations are such that you can use these standard formulas. That's it. Next is find Laplace inverse of log of p plus 1 over p minus 1. Now there is no logarithmic function. It looks very difficult. No idea. How can we do this problem? Suppose inverse Laplace is fx. So what is lfx? Somehow I want to get rid of this log function. See how I do that. Lfx is equal to log p plus 1 over p minus 1. I can write them separately also. Log p plus 1 minus log p minus 1.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, if we have divided it by 1 by 2, sir, the integral ban jata hai na, sir, direct. 1 by 2 in log x minus 1 for x plus 1.
Integral ban jata hai. You are finding inverse Laplace, isn't it? It is not Laplace.
नहीं सर, अभी तो हमको लाप्लास ही चाहिए ना, एल ऑफ एफ एक्स, एल ऑफ एफ पी.
I don't know what you are thinking, but let's complete it. Probably then we'll understand. So,
sir, can we use a sine hyperbolic x here? Because log p plus 1 upon p minus 1 can be used from there also.
Okay, let's
from look at formula 11.
You did do from your approach. I'm telling you something simple.
Okay.
First, I want to get rid of this logarithmic function. So let's multiply x by fx. Means fx by x. So what would happen on the right hand side if you multiply by x? See this number 10.
Differentiated.
Minus 1 times differentiated. So you get 1 over p plus 1 minus 1 over p minus 1. Solve it. P minus 1 p plus 1. So what do you get? 2 over p square minus 1. Check it. P minus 1 minus p. 2 over p square minus 1. So this is going as Laplace of x fx. So what is x fx? Inverse Laplace of this. Inverse Laplace of 1 over p square minus 1. This you know directly. 1 over p square minus 1 means sine hyperbolic x. Or you can make partial fractions, it's up to you. So what is fx finally? 2 sine hyperbolic x over x. 2 sine hyperbolic x over x. So this is one approach. If you find it difficult, you can use some other. Okay. Idea is to use some of these. So whatever way you find it suitable, you can go for this. But final answer would be same, remember that. Okay, see one more. P over p power 4 plus p square plus 1. See how can you manage it?
We can break it into 1 upon p square minus p plus 1 plus 1 upon p square plus p.
Yeah, so it's a very tricky problem because it is power 4. So first you break it in terms of two quadratics. But how to do that? This can be written as p square minus p plus 1. Okay, let me write the intermediate step also. I can write it p power 4 minus or plus 2p square plus 1 minus p square. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Now this can be written as 1 over p square plus 1 whole square minus p square. This can further be written as p square plus 1 minus p plus p and p square plus 1 minus p. Now make partial fractions. You can write it 1 over
1 by 2
p square minus p plus 1 minus 1 over p square plus p plus 1. What is extra? If you take LCM,
1 by 2.
Then you will get 2 in the numerator, so balance that 1 by 2. Now these are simply two quadratics. You can deal with them. Make perfect square here. These are, you can write inverse Laplace of this minus inverse Laplace of this.
Sir, it would be 1 by 2p.
How?
Yes, sir, it would be 1 by 2p.
P is running.
Oh.
up to this step p is here in the numerator. Okay, so that p is cancelled. Can you do it further yourself before I do it and check the answer? Okay, I do one part, that is half L inverse 1 over P square minus P plus 1. Other is similar. I'm going for this, okay? First, you need to make perfect square. What is perfect square of this?
So P minus 1 whole square plus P.
P minus half whole square plus root 3 by 2 whole square. Am I right? Is this okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. After that, what do you need to adjust?
Sir, root 3 by 2.
Root 3 by 2. Multiply root 3 by 2 divide.
And e raised to the power minus 1 by 2.
So is it 1 by root 3? P power x by 2, because p has gone to p minus half.
Minus x by
2. Yeah. So into sine root 3 by 2 x. Is it correct?
E raised to the power minus x by 2, I think.
No, it should be plus. Look this formula. When you multiply by e power ax, it goes to p minus a. You need to multiply by e power x by 2.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So likewise, you can do the second part. It's similar. So you have seen different problems, how we have done manipulations. So it's all about practice, okay? Keep these formulas in your mind and then do the problems. Okay, now I move to the next topic. That is the main purpose actually. Solution of differential equations using Laplace transform. Solution of differential equation using Laplace transform. I directly begin with an example because it's very simple. You will understand what's going on. I write a differential equation y prime minus y equal to 0. Very simple differential equation, first order. What is its solution from the earlier methods, you know? What is its solution?
C e power x.
Y equal to c times e power x. Very simple. Now let's solve it using Laplace transform. So first step, it's very important because you are definitely going to get a problem in the exam related to solution of differential equation using Laplace transform. So first step that you have to write, taking Laplace transform on both sides of the differential equation. So what do we get? Laplace transform of y prime minus Laplace of y right hand side is of course 0. So what is Laplace of y prime? Which formula will help you here? Number 8. What is number 8? P times Laplace of fx, in place of fx you have y, so you should write p times Laplace of y, or you can write capital Y, it's up to you, minus y0, minus f zero. You can see p times Laplace of f x minus f zero. So here p times Laplace of y minus y zero minus Laplace of y equal to zero. What is the idea in solving a differential equation? You need y in terms of x. Correct? So somehow we have to obtain y from this. See how we do it. P times, combine ly terms. You can write p minus 1 ly. Y0 is certainly a constant. Let's denote it by c. So what is ly from it? C over p minus 1. Now you understand what's the next step. To get one. Yes, you should write taking inverse Laplace transform on both sides. Taking inverse Laplace transform on both sides. So you get y equal to inverse Laplace of c over p minus 1. And you know c is constant. Laplace inverse of 1 over p minus 1 is e power x. So you see, you are getting the same solution. Okay, so in the solution of differential equations, you have to use Laplace as well as inverse Laplace. Let's solve one more equation. Rather, you should solve and tell me the answer. Using Laplace transform, you need to solve it. Y double prime plus y equal to zero. Follow the steps I have told you and get to the answer. First, take Laplace transform, but remember that here double derivative. What is the formula for double derivative? Do you recall, or I should write?
P square f of p minus p times f of 0 minus f dash 0.
Okay, so I'm writing here Laplace transform f double prime x. It is p square f p minus p f 0 minus f prime 0. So use it. So you can write p square l y minus p f 0 means y 0 minus f prime 0 y prime 0 plus l y. Now collect the terms carrying l y. So you get p square plus 1 l y. Without l y, carry those terms to the right hand side. So you have p times y0. Let's assume y0 a constant c1, y prime 0 c2. So you get c1 times p plus c2. So what is ly from it? By the way, what is your answer? You are solving it.
It's in form of sin x and cos x.
Okay, so you are getting it like this, c1 p over p squared plus 1 plus c2 over p squared plus 1. After that, there is a simple step. Take inverse Laplace on both sides. So you get y equal to c1 times inverse Laplace of p over p squared plus 1. You can check from here. It is cos x. C2 times inverse Laplace of 1 over p squared plus 1 is sin x. So you know the solution already, you have done it. Okay, so I think you have understood the procedure for solving differential equations using Laplace transform. I will take up more examples in the next lecture. So be familiar with the calculation of Laplace transform and inverse Laplace transform. So that would be helpful. So we will meet tomorrow.